Let's go over more secrets in Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order that you totally want to find, including extra stim canisters that give you an extra health potion. And even later on in the game, you can unlock a skill so they also refill your force. It's pretty overpowered. So let's look at some locations and some other secrets in the game too. Would of course be awesome if you could leave a like on the video as it shows your support. And let's go. Thanks by the way to everyone who reached out with the location of the Bogling on the Mantis. You find this little companion under your ship in Bogano. Like after you unlock the force push, you can open this door and then this creature will join you on your ship. But he likes to hide. But yeah, thanks to many tips from people who reached out, thanks again. I found him in the vent on your ship. But Jack also reached out on Twitter and he spotted the creature under the holo table. So yeah, just a fun little extra you totally want to get in for on your ship. And in that area you also find another stim canister. But yeah, we already touched on that in the previous video. For the first one of this video, we want to go to Sevo. And we will actually stay there because there are a ton of secrets there. I want to focus on the awesome crash site on this planet. It's not that hard to get there. It's over here on the map. And you need to actually go here for one of the main story missions. So maybe if you've already been here, then you can also use a shortcut if you unlock that one, and that is right from your ship through this door, slide down the ice, and then you want to get to the elevator by going straight, like past all the enemies, or you can take them out of course, and then making a right turn, force slow these things so you can jump on them, do the wall run, and then get to the elevator. And then you'll see a meditate point. You actually want to go via the water to this very large area. And there are three very interesting locations here. Let's focus on that main story area where you can actually get a two stim canister upgrade. So to get to this location, we want to go from the middle circle, climb up here, and then move to the left. Be careful for the probe droids that will be shooting you. You can ignore them or take them out, of course. And then we already see a stim canister like teasing us there on top of the hill. But we will get that one later on in the video. It's namely not something that you can get while doing this path. For now, let's continue. Use BD1 to overcharge here. This is something you get by just playing through the story. And then continue, and now you will get to the Imperial dig site. With a ton of zip lines, and here you will actually learn the power to use the zip lines to get higher up instead of only down. And that is needed for this stim canister. So from the meditate point, you want to get back to the bridge with all the troopers. And now instead of going through the door where you could get this zipline upgrade, we want to actually go and use this zipline to get back to the meditate point. But instead of going back to the meditate point, you want to let go before you are being launched. And yes, this will totally take some trial and error. Just try and let go earlier than you think you should. Because even if you like fall down then, you will respawn near the zipline. Otherwise you have to backtrack all the way. It will totally be worth it to try it multiple times to get on the platform, because then you will get to a small area where you can get some XP and the canister upgrade. For the other canister upgrades, we want to stay in this area and we actually want to go to the other side here. And this is after you take out the purge trooper and sort of like disable the red screen. So while you can easily get to the other side by wall running to the right, we need actually the force pull, and with the force pull you can use this rope to swing to the other side. So near the meditate points, you actually want to grab the rope and then launch yourself in the air and make sure that you hit the zip line so you can easily get to the other side. This might also take a few tries, but it's not that hard as the jump from earlier. Either way, when you hit the zip line and get to the other side, you can find the steam canister here. So before we talk about a big chest room where you can actually get the very cool starfighter poncho, the orange one, and the steam canister on the hill. Now first I want to talk about the area on the left of the crash site. So this is where you fight this Jotas over here. Near this fight, you can find a poncho that is actually pretty cool. You can get it by climbing higher up and then simply jumping to the other side. It's in the chest over here. And then we want to make our way inside. And you need to use the overcharge here from BD1 to remove the red screen. And you can find the red screen where you actually climb up. And then you can squeeze yourself inside. Here you will find a mini boss. the rabbit Jotas. And you want to be careful during this fight, because when you die, you actually go back to the last meditate point, and that is likely very far away. If you want a head start, then you want to climb higher and jump on him and do a nice air attack. It will totally help. But still, the area is pretty small for this encounter, so be careful. Strike after he's done with his combos. It's kind of similar to the regular Jotas, but he seems to be more aggressive. And if you were successful, you can ignore the boss, although you will return to this location. So it will be smart to take the guy out. Either way, then you can just continue and explore this area for the secrets. Force push, get through the tunnel, fall down, and then in the end, you'll reach a location where you have to fight a security droid. Here you can find one of the secrets, but you first wanna cut the wire that is in the water so that when you overcharge, there will not be electricity in the water. Then you wanna stop BD1 at the right time so you can actually jump up here and get this small little secret. It's just a nice XP, why not get it? But the actual price is after you take the elevator in that same area and then go up, and there you will find a force essence. Okay, now let's go to that insane chest location where we can also get the steam canister. You actually need double jump to get to this location. And you unlock this actually by just following the main story. And then when you have to return to Kashyyyk for the second time, you unlock this very nice upgrade. And you want to use it in the middle of the crash sites, like over here on the map. So climb up, and first we would go to the left for the main story location, but now we want to go straight. And then you actually unlock a completely new area after sliding down here and dodging the electricity. So overall, we just want to complete this area, but there are a few things that you want to look out for. And then in the end, we get to that awesome chest room and the steam canister. So at one point in the larger area, you find this moving bridge that you want to stop at the right time, and you can go to the right here or go straight. I would suggest you go straight, because in the end you get to the same spot, although going straight will actually get you to an extra room. Either way, you will find a purge trooper, but more interesting are these sort of bounty hunters that will be hunting you down, and I really love this part of the game. So this means that sometimes in areas you find these mini bosses that will attack you, and when you die they might disappear. So sometimes you only got one shot at them. In this instance, you want to use the environment, because if you push them against the electricity, you do massive damage. I want to do a more in-depth video on these special encounters, so if you fought some of these bounty hunters already, let me know where so we can all find them and take them out. You can of course let me know in the comments under this video, or reach out to me on social media, Twitter and Instagram, above your raptor. And I really like them because they are random, like they don't show up all the time, and the fights are pretty challenging and unique. So good luck, hopefully you take these guys out, and otherwise if you die they might disappear. Either way, past this point there is a force essence, like just follow it, then you get all the way up. Important is to cut the wire, of course, so you create a shortcut so you can get here from the meditate point. And here you can find a force essence. You will likely already see it here on the left. And what you need to do is just swing with the force pull, and no need to hurry. Just when you get close enough, jump, maybe do the double jump, and then you can get it. And then you can jump down, but we actually want to make our way up again. Like you need to swing to the other side instead of jumping to get the force essence. Here you just want to continue, maybe blast the rocket from the rocket launcher trooper in his face. One of the coolest things you can do in this game, in my opinion. And then in the end, you will reach a room with a small puzzle. And after that, you get to that amazing room with the many chests. There are still some enemies in this room, so careful for that. But then just open all the chests. And then you will get a lightsaber material, a BD1 skin, and that awesome orange poncho. Then you go outside and you find that steam canister that has been teasing us this whole time. Subscribe for way more Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order videos. I will have way more up, so totally keep an eye out for more secrets, tips and tricks and stuff like that. Like the video to support the channel. You can check out my previous tips and tricks video by clicking on the screen. And yes, that puzzle, for if you want to know, what you want to do is like make sure the block moves to the right first, so you can jump and then slash the wire. Then you will fall down. But you want to go back to the block, because then you want to move it to the left. And now you can use this block to wall run here and then jump to the right, and then you made it to the other side. I will speak to you next time. For now, have fun with the game. I'm going to jump back in as well, and goodbye.